Do you need something? Honestly, I don't think they care what a bunch of vampires would do with Auriel's bow. They're pretty focused on the past. As long as we can get this Vyrthur out of the Sanctum, I think they'll be happy to just hand it over.
You've arrived at the Way Shrine of Resolution. Are you prepared to honor the mantras of Auriel and fill your vessel with his enlightenment? Then go forth, child. May the enrichment of Auriel strengthen your resolve as you undertake your journey to the Inner Sanctum.
Skyrim weather I've always heard about.
You've reached the Way Shrine of Learning, Initiate. Are you prepared to honor the mantras of Auriel and fill your vessel with his enlightenment? Auriel bless you, child, for you are a step closer to the inner sanctum and everlasting wisdom. Welcome, Initiate. This is the Way Shrine of Sight. Are you prepared to honor the mantras of Auriel and fill your vessel with his enlightenment? Then behold Auriel's gift, my child. May it speed your journey to the inner sanctum.
Something's not right here. Be careful. I think we may be in for some trouble.
You found the Way Shrine of Radiance, Initiate. Are you prepared to honor the mantras of Auriels and fill your vessel with his enlightenment? May the blessings of Auriels protect you as you climb the road to the inner sanctum and final enlightenment.
spell's radiance fill your heart with joy.
Did you really come here expecting to claim Auriel's bow? You've done exactly as I predicted and brought your fetching companion to me.
Wait, is he talking about me?
Which, I'm sorry to say, means your usefulness is at an end.
Where'd you come from? enough, Vyrthur. Give us the bow.
How dare you? I was the Arch-Curate of Auriel, girl. I had the ears of a god.
Until the betrayed corrupted you. Yes, yes, we've heard this sad story.
Gelebor and his kind are easily manipulated fools. Look into my eyes, Serana. You tell me what I am.
You're a vampire? But Auriel should have protected you.
The moment I was infected by one of my own initiates, Auriel turned his back on me. I swore I'd have my revenge, no matter what the cost.
You want to take revenge on a god?
Auriel himself may have been beyond my reach, but his influence on our world wasn't. All I needed was the blood of a vampire and his own weapon, Auriel's bow.
The blood of a vampire? Auriel's bow? It was you? You created that prophecy?
A prophecy that lacked a single final ingredient. The blood of a pure vampire. The blood of a daughter of Cold Harbor.
Waiting all this time for someone with my blood to come along. Well, too bad for you. I intend on keeping it. Let's see if your blood has any power to it.
What trickery is this?
Where'd you come from?
Deed has been done. The restoration of this way shrine means that Vyrthur must be dead, and the betrayed no longer have control over him. What? What are you talking about? A vampire. I see. That would explain much. Deep inside, it brings me joy that the betrayed weren't to blame for what happened here. Because that means there's still hope that they might one day shed their hatred and learn to believe in Auriel once again. It's been a long time since I felt that way, and it's been long overdue. My thanks to both of you. You risked everything to get Auriel's bow. And in turn, you've restored the Chantry. I can't think of a more deserving champion to carry it than you. If you wish to learn more about the bow, or obtain Sunhallowed Arrows for it, I'd be more than happy to help. You've but to ask. Please, take the bow. It's yours. Even with Vyrthur gone, and the Inner Sanctum destroyed, my duty as a Knight-Paladin of Auriel remains. I have been sworn to protect this Vale and everything it represents until I die. For the time being, they will remain open. If remnants of our kind who escaped the betrayal at the hands of the dwarfs exist out there, perhaps they will find this place one day. May Auriel watch over you. I feel nothing but sympathy for the betrayed, despite my actions against them. But I'm afraid that they're well beyond a cure at this point. The twisted forms you've seen didn't occur overnight. It isn't a plague or a disease that ravaged our species. The dwarves may have stolen their sight, but it took many generations for them to become what they are today. Perhaps they'll never return to their former appearance. But over the centuries, I've noticed a rise in their intellect. If a line of communication could be established with them, maybe they can find peace. It's the only way they'll discover that they weren't always malignant. They were once a proud and prosperous race. While it would fill me with joy to see the Chantry back to its former glory, that time has long since passed. Now that my brother's dead, it's quite possible I'm the last of our kind. There's no need for that kind of talk. I said it was possible. It's also quite possible that there are some other isolated conclaves of snow elves nestled elsewhere on Nern. I'll also assume Vyrthur didn't exactly give you the option to stay your hand. For the time being, I will remain here, on the Overlook, and continue trying to keep the Sanctum free of the betrayed. You're always welcome to return here at any time, of course. The bow was said to be carried by Auriel himself into battle against the forces of Lorcan in ancient and mythic times. Its craftsmanship has no equal anywhere within Tamriel, and possibly beyond. The bow draws its power from Aetherius itself, channeling it through the sun. Therefore, when an arrow is loosed from the bow, it produces a magical effect very similar to being burned by fire. That's actually only a fraction of its potential. With sun-hallowed arrows, you would be able to produce a much more spectacular effect, causing bursts of sunlight to envelop your foes. The sunbursts would certainly hurt anything, but is especially devastating to the undead. Well, using an arrow with the bow that's been dipped in blood may cause it to function differently, corrupting its purpose. That's, of course, if you're foolish enough to try it. Farewell, friend. May the radiance of Auriel fill your heart with joy.